So continuing with electrochemistry, we do some more questions. Question number one of this lecture, number three, define resistance. R of a conductor. Resistance R of conductor is the relative unease और obstruction कितनी बाधा पेश आती है to the passage of current. Units of R that is ohm. तो कितनी मुश्किल से करंट किसी कंडक्टर में से गुजरता है उसको हम रेजिस्टेंस कहते हैं. इट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द लेंथ ऑफ द कंडक्टर एंड इट इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन. So this is resistance of a conductor. Then we have specific resistance. First of all, we do specific resistance. It is represented by rho. It is the resistance of one cubic centimeter of a conducting material, a conductor. As we know that R is proportional to L upon A, removing sign of proportionality by constant rho, if L is equal to 1 centimeter, A is equal to 1 square centimeter, then R is equal to. So specific resistance is the resistance of 1 cubic centimeter of a conducting material. If you want to find out the units of rho, rho will be equal to Ra upon L. What is R? It is ohm. A centimeter square. L centimeter head. Unit will be ohm centimeter. So these are the units. Then we have question number 3. Define and give units of kappa. Kappa is specific conductance or conductivity. So conductivity we have already defined. It is the conducting power of 1 cubic centimeter of a conducting material, or we can say it is the conducting power of a conductor whose length is 1 centimeter, area of cross section is 1 square centimeter, and it is reciprocal of rho. Kappa is actually reciprocal of rho. Units agar aap dena chahe to ye unit hum reverse kar denge. इसका यूनिट हो जाएगा ओम इनवर्स सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स. ओम इनवर्स की जगह हम साइमन भी लिख सकते हैं, साइमन सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स. तो दीज आर द यूनिट्स ऑफ कप्पा एंड इट इज टू बी कैप्ट इन द माइंड दैट स्पेसिफिक कंडक्टेंस इट ऑलवेज डिक्रीजेस विद द इंक्रीज इन डिल्यूशन इन केस ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक कंडक्टर्स बिकॉज डिल्यूशन नो डाउट इंक्रीजेस द नंबर ऑफ आयंस in the electrolytic solution, but number of ions per cubic centimeter of a conducting material that decreases. That's why we say specific conductance, it always decreases with the increase in dilution, because number of ions per cubic centimeter of a conducting material that decreases. So this is very important case of specific conductance. Then we have very important case, that is what is cell constant. सेल कांस्टेंट की हमें जरूरत क्यों पड़ी और सेल कांस्टेंट क्या होता है, लेट अस सी दैट. तो सेल कांस्टेंट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय जी स्टार. इट इज एक्चुअली रिप्रेजेंटेड, इट इज इक्वल टू एल अपॉन ए एंड एल अपॉन ए दैट इज इक्वल टू कापा अपॉन जी दैट इज कंडक्टेंस conductivity over conductance. So cell constant, what was the necessity to introduce the term cell constant? It is very easy to determine the length of a solid conductor, solid metallic conductor, to know its area of cross section. But in case of the electrolytic conductors, it is not easy to determine the length as well as area of cross section of the conductor, because the distance between electrodes, which are not fixed, it always go on changing. They keep on moving in the solution, and the electrolytic ion that will also change, the area of cross section will also change. Therefore, scientists derived an expression. By taking this into account, they derived an expression that cell constant can be calculated by knowing the specific conductance and conductance of that cell. Derivation iska hum kaise kar sakte hain? Agar hum baat karein, we'll take this expression, rho is equal to, we'll take rho is equal to Ra upon L. Or you can write L by A that is equal to R की जगह आप कंडक्टेंस डाल सकते हैं क्योंकि ये रेसिप्रोकल है. That will be L by A that is equal to R A upon rho. और rho का उल्टा क्या होता है? That is kappa. इसका उल्टा क्या है? That is G. तो L upon A क्या बन गया? Kappa upon G. तो conductivity upon conductance that will give you cell constant, which is also represented by G star. And it is used for determination of length as well as area of cross section of the electrolytic conductor. That's why the term cell constant is given. And this can be determined where the actual calculation was not possible in case of the electrolytic conductors. Then we have very important question on the Nernst equation. If you are given an electrode and you are given the concentration of that electrode, and you are asked to calculate its electrode potential under those conditions under which this electrode is working, then we can use Nernst equation. We have already used it to calculate EMF of the cell. Now question number 5 is calculate electrode potential of copper electrode if concentration of copper sulfate is 0.1 m. तो इसके लिए सीधा आपने ये Nernst equation लगानी है. Nernst equation क्या कहती है? Electrode potential of an electrode which is working under some non-standard condition, it is given by E0, that is from electrochemical series. Then we have plus 0.059 upon n, how many electron copper can accept, here two positive charge is there, so it can accept two electrons. Then we have log of molar concentration of copper sulfate, कितना है? 0.1 है. तो ये आपने लेना है copper का table में value जो है 0.34 होती है. You put that value plus 0.059, it accepts two electron divided by two, log 10 आ जाएगा, log 10 is equal to 1, ये solve कर लेना, you will get the answer. 0.34 plus 0.0245 ये ऐड कर देना है आपने, तो दिस विल बी 585. सो दिस इज द वोल्टेज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल ऑफ कॉपर इलेक्ट्रोड अंडर विच इट इज वर्किंग, जिन कंडीशन में काम कर रहा है. मान लीजिए इसी तरह आपको जिंक इलेक्ट्रोड का निकालना और फिर ईएमएफ निकालने को कहता, तो दोनों का आपने अलग अलग कैलकुलेशन कर लेना है, जिंक का भी कॉपर का भी अलग अलग कंसंट्रेशन पे. एंड देन यू विल हैव फार्मूला, यू विल फाइंड द फार्मूला ईएमएफ ऑफ द सेल दैट इज इक्वल टू ईएमएफ नॉट प्लस 0.059 अपॉन 2 लॉग ऑफ, इफ इट इज प्लस साइन देन कॉपर कंसंट्रेशन विल बी एट टॉप एंड जिंक कंसंट्रेशन एट बॉटम. तो इसी तरह से अगर आपको जिंक का भी इसी में कहा जाता कि जिंक की कंसंट्रेशन भी जो है वो है 0.01 m, तो आपने फिर इसका भी कैलकुलेट कर लेना था और ये कंसंट्रेशन ही बराबर होना था जिंक के केस में, दिस वुड हैव बीन -0.76 प्लस 0.059 अपॉन 2 लॉग ऑफ 10^2 हो जाता है. तो इसको सॉल्व करके और फिर आपने डिफरेंस लेके ईएमएफ कैलकुलेशन कर लेना था. देन वी हैव ए क्वेश्चन, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. वी हैव डन दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन अर्लियर आल्सो. कैन कॉपर स्पून बी यूज्ड टू स्टीर ए सॉल्यूशन ऑफ सिल्वर नाइट्रेट? क्या कॉपर के चम्मच से हम सिल्वर नाइट्रेट के सॉल्यूशन को हिला सकते हैं, क्या कोई रिएक्शन होगा नहीं होगा, एडवाइजेबल क्या है, वेदर वी कैन शेक AgNO3 सॉल्यूशन विद कॉपर स्पून और नॉट। सो लेट अस डू दैट क्वेश्चन, इट इज आवर क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। कैन वी स्टेयर AgNO3 सॉल्यूशन विद कॉपर स्टेरर, हिलाने वाला जो स्टेरर होगा उससे क्या हिला सकते हैं। इस केस में कॉपर न्यूट्रल मेटल है और ये आयनिक मेटल है, तो हमेशा ऐसे प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व करते हुए आपको नेट इन और देखना है कि इनमें कितना पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस सेटअप होता है। तो सिल्वर नाइट्रेट आयनिक फेज का जो वैल्यू है वो है 0.80 सिल्वर का इलेक्ट्रॉन पोटेंशियल माइनस जो न्यूट्रल फेज है, तो अगर ये सब्सट्रैक्ट करें तो 0.46 पॉजिटिव वैल्यू आती है। If net anode is positive, then reaction is possible. We should not stir the copper sulfate in silver nitrate solution with copper spoon. Since net anode is positive, so reaction is possible. यहाँ पे reaction हो जाएगी, silver copper से react कर देगा. Therefore, we should not stir. AgNO3 solution with copper. Copper stirrer से हमारा हिलाना नहीं बनता है, copper stirrer जो है that will dissolve in the solution. So this is very important question. Now we have another important question. Define and explain Faraday's laws of electrolysis. So there are two Faraday's laws of electrolysis. First of all, we have Faraday's first law. What does this law states? It states that the weight of a substance deposited at its electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through its voltmeter. We can say W is proportional to Q or Q is equal to IT. So W is proportional to IT. Removing sign of proportionality by another constant which is called as electrochemical equivalent. This constant Z, so Z is called as ECE, electrochemical equivalent. So Z ko nikalna aur Z is equal to W upon Q or it is equal to W upon IT. Now, what are the applications of Faraday's first law? Number one is, it helps us to calculate quantity of electricity, Q. Number two, it helps us to calculate Z of any metal. Z के लिए आपको सीधा लेना है एटॉमिक वेट ऑफ द मेटल अपॉन वैलेंसी एंड मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 96,500 कूलम और इक्विवेलेंट वेट बटे फैराडे दैट इज 96,500 कूलम, ग्राम में आप लेंगे दिस विल बी इन कूलम। सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, फैराडेज फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस। नाउ वी कम टू Faraday's second law of electrolysis, that is question number 8. Define and give applications of Faraday's second law of electrolysis. Question number 8. Define Faraday's second law of electrolysis and give its applications. Now, what is Faraday's second law? It states that when same quantity of electricity is passed through different voltammeters by connecting them in series, then the weights of different substances deposited in their respective voltammeters, they are in the ratio of their equivalent weights. Tab wo jo weights honge unke, they will be in the ratio of their equivalent weight. So how we can pass the same quantity of electricity through different voltammeters by connecting them in series? Suppose we are having two voltammeters, one is copper voltammeter, another is silver voltammeter. In case of the copper voltammeter, the W1 is the weight of copper deposited, that will be proportional to its equivalent weight. Similarly, the copper voltammeter. Similarly, in silver voltammeter, W2 weight of silver, that will be proportional to its equivalent weight. So combining 1 and 2, W1 upon W2, it will be equal to E1 upon E2. Weight of copper upon weight of silver deposited, that is equal to equivalent weight of copper upon equivalent weight of silver. This is our second law. Applications iski kya hai? First application, it helps us to calculate equivalent weight. Equivalent weight of metal. Agar teen cheeze is formula mein hame pata ho, ye 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 aur ye nikal sakte hain. Dusra, it helps us to calculate Q. क्वांटिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी भी हम कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं. देन वी हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, डिफाइन फैराडे. फैराडे क्या है? फैराडे इज द चार्ज कैरिड बाय वन मोल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. एक मोल इलेक्ट्रॉन्स का कितना चार्ज कैरी करते हैं? तो वन फैराडे, that is equal to 1.602 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb multiplied by how many electrons contained in 1 mole. This value comes out to be 96,480. Approximately it has been taken as 96,500 coulomb. To make the calculations easy, this is our 1 Faraday. Then we have, what is ECE? Electrochemical equivalent Z. So what is it? ECE, it is the weight of substance deposited when 1 coulomb of electricity is passed through voltammeter of the substance. एक कूलम अगर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पास की जाए उस वक्त जो ग्रेड जमेगा, we know W is equal to ZIT. If I is 1 ampere, T is 1 second, 1 ampere 1 second के लिए गुजारा जाए, that constitute 1 कूलम, then W will be equal to what? Z. So what is Z here? It is the weight of substance deposited when 1 coulomb of electricity or 1 ampere of current is passed through the voltammeter of the substance for 1 second. That is called as electrochemical equivalent of the substance. Iske liye formula hum pehle kar chuke hain. Z can be calculated by dividing equivalent weight of the substance with Faraday's 96,500 coulombs. This is all about this lecture. Then we'll take in the other questions in the next lecture.